Senator, yield.
I yield.
Distinguished leader, is it not true that we have your assurance that it, once these matters are rectified, that you'll do all you can at meeting with the House later to make sure the underlying bill from the senator from the 35th gets a fair hearing and has every opportunity to proceed?
You betcha. And those meetings go on all day. There's a lot of times where you'll see us taking breaks in here, and the public probably wonders, why are they gone? This is the last day. Well, a lot of those meetings are occurring during our breaks, and I'll be doing that. And sometimes you can find an appropriate vehicle, a related subject matter bill that this could be attached to or amended to, and we'll be trying to do that within the rules, and we're certainly going to try to get any bill that passed this body out of the House and back to us in a form that is constitutional so that we can get on with the business of the people of Georgia. Thank you.
No further questions.
Thank you, Mr. President. I yield the will.
Senator from the 26th, you wish to be recognized. You're recognized.
You know, I've seen this over and over. You know, you serve here 42 years, you see the games that are being played between the House and the Senate, because I used to do them. I used to be on the House side then. Mr. President, I would like for us to take up the agrees and the disagrees before we deal with any bill that we table, so that if we are going to do something, the conference committees can go to work to try to resolve the differences between the Senate and the House. We ought to try to do that rather than take up all these bills. I mean, we were here the other night, and the senator from the 46th came down and said, look, they just killed a bill without anything. We adjourn. So rather than, you know, we talk about it, we can play the game too. Now, I would assume that everybody over here has got some common sense. Don't have to have a college degree, but just some common sense. So I would say to all of you, rather than take up the table bills we have on the calendar, that we go through the agrees and disagrees and allow the president to appoint the conference committees, and then we go back to work on the bills that we table. I think that would help us in doing a lot of things, and as the senator from the 46th talked about. So, Mr. President, I'd like to be recognized when I go back to my seat for a motion. Are there any questions?
No questions.
I thought I was pretty clear.
The question is on germaneness. Senator from 26, what purpose you rise?
Because of the discussion on Senate bills that have gone to the House, that automatically, that we go to the agrees and disagrees to give our folks an opportunity to be on a conference committee to try to work out the difference before we take up any bills that we table today's Thursday, that we table Tuesday.
Thank you, Senator. I think you and I are on the same. Question for Senate Bill 104. Obviously, the amendment, again, that the House has put on a Senate bill is not germane. I am hopeful that the House will get the message and begin to take up the bills of importance to both the House and the Senate. Chair recognizes we're going to take up some insist at this time. Chair recognizes the Senator from the 52nd.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move that the Senate insist on its substitute to House Bill 340.
Read the caption.
House Bill 340 by Residents Blackman, the 146th and others, a bill will be titled an act amend 5C of Title 40 to the OCGA relating to alternative ad valorem tax on motor vehicles and for other purposes. That concludes the order.
Is there objection? Without objection, the Senate has insisted on its substitute to House Bill 340. Chair recognizes Senator from the 6th. No, 52nd again, I believe.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move that the Senate insist on its substitute to House Bill 329.
329, read the caption.
House Bill 329 by President Powell, the 171st, and others, a bill will be titled an act amend Article 3, Chapter 7, Title 40 of the OCGA, relating to imposition, rate, and computation of and exemptions from income taxes so as to modify the rate of tax imposed on the Georgia taxable net income of individuals and for other purposes. That concludes the order.
Is there objection? Without objection, the Senate has insisted on its substitute to House Bill 329. Chair recognizes Senator from the 25th.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move that the Senate insist on its position on House Bill 205.
Senators moving to insist. Secretary will read the caption.
House Bill 205 by Representative Meadows of the 5th and others, a bill be titled an act amend Article 2, Chapter 4 of Title 12 of the CGA relating to mining and drilling so as to regulate the exploration and extraction of gas and oil in the state and for other purposes. That concludes the order.
Is there objection? Without objection, the Senate has insisted upon its posture to insist yet. Chair recognizes Senator from the 25th again for a motion.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move that the Senate disagree with the House amendment to the Senate substitute.
Disagreeing, the Senator from the 25th is disagreeing with the House amendment. The bill has been read. Is there objection? Without objection, the Senate has disagreed. Chair recognizes the Majority Leader, Senator from the 46th.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move the Senate disagree with the House amendment to the Senate substitute to House Bill 222.
Read the caption.
House Bill 222 by Representative Blackman, 146 and others, a bill be titled an act to amend Part 7, Article 7 of Chapter 3 of Title 20 of the OCGA, relating to HOPE scholarships and grants so as to provide that members of the Georgia National Guard and Reservists meet residency requirements and other purposes. That concludes the order.
Is there objection? Without objection, the Senate has disagreed to the House amendment to the Senate substitute to House Bill 222. Chair recognizes Senator from the 45th.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move that the Senate agree to the House substitute to Senate Bill 4 as amended by the Senate, but I would like to come to the well and speak about it.
Read the caption.
Senate Bill 4 by Senator Zuntman of the 45th and others, the bill will be titled an act to amend Article 7, Chapter 4 of Title 49 of the OCGA relating to medical assistance generally so as to establish the Georgia Mental Health Treatment Task Force and for other purposes. Amendment 1 by Senator Zuntman of the 45th offers the following amendment. Amend the House Committee on Health and Human Services substitute Senate Bill 4 by deleting 21 and replacing 20 in line 84 by deleting line 95 and for other purposes. That concludes the order.
Chair recognizes Senator from the 45th to speak to the motion.
Thank you, Mr. President. Members of the Senate, I appreciate you giving me the opportunity to have the well and to talk about that. I do agree with that as amended Senate Bill 4. But because I'm in the well and because I want to take this opportunity to kind of voice what's on my mind, everybody else has voiced what's on their mind, I got quite a few things on my mind and I want to get them off my chest, make sure I start out this day right. First of all, let me just say I appreciate Steen Miles, former senator from the 43rd. She was my seatmate right back there and I can still hear her lovely voice. Oh my gosh. I wish I would have had that TV and radio voice and that wonderful laughter. She was a wonderful human being. She and I worked on a lot of issues together. We worked on a lot of social service issues together, and we agreed on a lot of issues together. I also want to say my sweet mate, the senator from the 39th, is running for mayor, and we wish him the best of luck. And another former senator, we wished him the best of luck, and lo and behold, he became the mayor of the city of Atlanta. So I think we got a pretty good track record here, and I think the senator from the 39th has a good track record. One of the things that I wanted to talk about this morning, while it's still morning, is that there was a parody on television and on a video that was brought up last night. And it was a TV talk show host, if you want to call that, a comedian, and her name is Samantha Bee. And I had never heard of Samantha Bee, and that was from last year, and that was talking about the rape kits from last year. And evidently somebody in Hollywood has a favoritism for me, and I think it's because I'm a good Republican, and they like to make fun of me. But let me tell you, I like for Samantha Bee, and if you don't know her, I don't suggest that you look her up because she's so vile and the language she uses is so awful. But I appreciate her. You know what? I come from Hillary Clinton, Pelosi mantra that she eschews. I can tell you that that does me more good than it hurts me. And for Samantha Bee to keep it up. But the one thing I don't appreciate, and it's a lot about fake news and fake comedy, is the fact that she put on there House members. And I can tell you, I served in the House for 4 years. And some of the language that is on this video, including the F word, I just don't approve. And I don't care who you are, what you are, I think you deserve respect. I think you deserve courtesy. You may not agree with me because I come from that red meat Republican district, but everyone in this room, everyone across the hall, and especially our constituents that we represent, we deserve respect. And there was not respect. And I can tell you, they couldn't even, and the reason I say it's fake news, they couldn't even get it right. They had in it that Georgia has 131 congressional districts. Now, everyone knows there's no state in the union that has 131 congressional districts. But I'm surprised that the House didn't take up. And I'm surprised that the House and the Speaker allows this to take place and that there is not a condemnation about it, because I know this man standing right behind me, wherever he is back here, that if something happened to any of the 56 senators in here, this man right here would be Johnny on the spot. And he would be standing up for you no matter what kind of district you represented and no matter where you came from, because he has that integrity. It's not a nice thing when you hit the national news like that, but then again, like I said, Hollywood helps me more than it hurts me. And keep it up. I'm a tough character. So the majority leader from the 46th was talking about the taking up of the important bills, and I agree with him wholeheartedly. And Mr. President, I don't think everybody's in here. I got something to say. Can you get them back in here? As most of y'all know, I am pretty tough. And I'm shaking right now because it's something I want to talk about. And most of y'all know my son died a few years ago now. And if it weren't for the Senate and the man standing behind me, I would never have gotten through it. So a lot of you asked me, Renee, why? That I care most about is mental health and mental health parity, mental health with physical health, that mental health is just as important as physical health. And you want to know why I feel that way? Because I had to walk down the steps of my pool house and go downstairs and literally scrape up my son who had killed himself. And when you do something like that, it makes you strong. You either survive or you go the way my son went. And it's a terrible, terrible thing when it's our mission in this body to talk about child sex trafficking, human sex trafficking, slavery of people, and mental health issues. And we have that passion that I have in my heart and my soul. And just because a petty political process on the 40th day of a session, we cannot take care of children and adults who have issues like my son had. I appeal to you, I appeal to the Speaker. It's not worth it. Because if we save one life with our platform here in the Senate about mental health issues, we can literally save the world. Because I hear from each one of you, Renee, we're taking these people to the hospital, but they don't get seen. There's a backlog. People with mental health issues wait 3 days to be seen. One of the most important bills I'm carrying this year is Senate Bill 40, and it came from my urban county. It's the ability to apprehend and transport people who want help so bad, just like my son did. But that bill is being blocked. Everyone in here voted for that bill. It can't even get out of the Rules Committee. So if you're not here when we're having this huge transfer, to interject ourselves during all of these fissures that are going on in Washington, D.C., and the state can work. We can work and we can help our people. What is wrong with us? What is it that we put the political process before the emotional well-being? One of the issues they talked about, they didn't want the sheriffs involved. Oh my God, all I've heard about is rural health care. Who takes care of the sick people in the rural areas? The sheriffs. Because if the sheriffs don't transport them, you don't get the access to care of where you need to go. Give me a break. It's nothing but petty politics. Just like Samantha Bee in Hollywood trying to tell us what to do in Georgia, that we cannot move our bills. Our bills are important. It's our Senate bill platform. They blocked Senate Resolution 307, the child sex trafficking, as a task force for the House and the Senate to look at. They're blocking it. I got a problem. And you know what? That feeling in my heart of when I walk down those steps, it's not going away. And I don't care if y'all don't like me or not. It doesn't matter, because I'm here to represent Georgians, and Georgians in need of health care, and whether it's physical health or mental health. And I'm pleading to you, and I'm pleading to the Speaker of the House, please, please, please let these mental health bills get through. Thank you very much, Mr. President.
The senator has moved that the Senate agree to the House substitute Senate Bill 4 as amended by the Senate. All those in favor will vote aye. Those opposed, no. Secretary, unlock the machine. On the pass of the bill, the yeas are on the motion to agree. The yeas are 52 and the nays are 0, and the Senate has agreed to the House substitute as amended. Chair recognizes Senator from the 37th.
It was an initiative of the Lieutenant Governor to expand education opportunities. There was a glitch that arose in that bill that had to do with Hope Scholarship or the Hope Grant. Senate Bill 186 corrects that, and it also has been expanded to include fictive kin to guarantee students in our education system whose parents cannot care for them, those students can be fully provided the opportunities of the education system. Mr. President, I move that the Senate agree to the House amendment to Senate Bill 186.
Read the caption.
Senate Bill 186 by Senators Tippins of the 37th and others, a bill be titled an act to amend Title 20 of the OCGA relating to education so as to clarify language relating to the effect of dual credit courses on Hope Scholarship and grant applicability, provide that students who worked a high school diploma through certain dual credit coursework are eligible for a Hope grant toward an associate degree and for other purposes. The amendment offers, the House offers the following amendment. Amend the committee substitute to Senate Bill 186 by striking line 4 and inserting in lieu thereof the following, an associate degree to amend Chapter 1 of Title 20 of the OCGA relating to general education provisions to provide for a kinship caregiver to give legal consent and for other purposes. That concludes the order.
The senator has moved that the Senate agree to the House's amendment to SB 186. All those in favor will vote aye. Those opposed, no. Secretary will unlock the machine. Senator from the 45th will stand by. On the motion, the ayes are 51, the nays are 0, and the Senate has agreed to the House amendment to SB 186. Chair recognizes Senator from the 45th.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move that the Senate agree to the House substitute to Senate Bill 193.
Read the caption.
Senate Bill 193 by Senator Unterman of the 45th and others, a bill titled an act to amend Article 2 of Chapter 2A of Title 31 of the OCGA relating to positive alternatives for pregnancy and parenting grant programs so as to revise the program mission and practice to remove certain references to medically indigent women and for other purposes. The House offers the following substitute to Senate Bill 193, a bill titled an act to amend Code 26480 and Title 31 of the OCGA relating to prescription drug orders and health respectfully so as to revise provisions to promote health pregnancies and revise the program mission and for other purposes. That concludes the order.
Chair recognizes Senator of the 45th.
Thank you, Mr. President. Senate Bill 193, if you recall, is the Pregnancy Resource Center bill. It was a cleanup bill. And when it went over to the House, as our leader has said, the senator from the 46th has said, everything we send over there comes back with something else on it. And the bill that's included on it is called the Buddy Bill. This gives the ability of physicians, when they see a woman who has a venereal disease, to give the mate or whoever the partner was that they suspect also has a problem to also give them a prescription without ever seeing them. We have worked on this bill for several years. This is the chairman of HHS's priority in the House, and we're agreeing in our spirit of trying to get along that we agree to attach this bill to the very important Senate Bill 193, which is the protection of the unborn. I'll yield for any questions, Mr. President. There's no questions. I yield the will and ask for your favorable consideration.
Senators move. The Senate agree to the House substitute Senate Bill 193. All those in favor will vote aye. Those opposed, no. Secretary, lock the machine. Senator from the ninth will stand by. Senator from the ninth. And then the senator from the first. On the motion to agree to the House substitute to SB 193, the yeas are 44 and the nays are 7, and the Senate has agreed. Chair recognizes the Senator from the ninth.
Mr. President, I move the Senate agree to the House substitute to SB 206.
Read the caption.
Senate Bill 206 by Senator Martin of the Ninth and others, a bill entitled An Act to Amend Chapter 24 of Title 33 of the OCJ relating to insurance generally, so as to provide for a short title and findings to require health plans to provide coverage for hearing aids for certain individuals and for other purposes. The House offers the following substitute Senate Bill 206, bill entitled An Act to Amend Chapter 4 of Title 33 of the OCJ relating to insurance generally, so as to provide for a short title and findings require health plans to provide coverage for hearing aids for certain individuals and for other purposes. That concludes the order.
Chair recognizes Senator from the Ninth.
Thank you, Mr. President. Today, I'm very proud to rise to agree to the House version of SB 206, the Hearing Aid Coverage for Children Act. The only change that the House made to this was to move the effective date out a few months to give insurance companies a chance to prepare. I believe, though, that this bill shows the Senate's tradition of being committed to the children of Georgia. We showed this commitment a couple years ago when we took on the autism debate and was able to pass that a few years ago. I was proud to author this bill and take the lead on this issue, but I also want to thank my colleagues in the body. I want to thank the president of this body. I want to thank our leadership, Chairman from the 53rd as well, for helping move this through the Senate. I also want to thank members of the House. I want to thank the senator from the 25th and also from the 20th and the 6th for their help in this bill as well. I also want to thank the House. I want to thank Representative Houston, Representative Raffensperger. I want to thank Representative Chairman Smith and also Chairman Meadows for their help in moving this through, and the Speaker who also helped move this important legislation through. There's another champion of this push, and that is Governor Deal, who helped work with us a few years ago to get this put into the state health benefit plan, which helps show how inexpensive this coverage was that's so valuable to the people of this state, to children all over this state. In closing, I do believe that this bill shows that the Senate of this state, the Senate of Georgia, that this chamber is committed to getting work done for the state of Georgia, regardless of what those across the hall may say. I ask for your vote to agree to the House version of SB 206.
Thank you, Senator. The Senator is moving. The Senate agree to the House substitute to SB 206. All those in favor will vote aye. Those opposed, no. Secretary, unlock the machine. Thank you. the motion, the yeas are 46 and the nays are 5. And this bill, this Senate has agreed to the House substitute. Chair recognizes Senator from the first.
Mr. President, I move that the Senate agree to the House substitute for Senate Bill 16.
Read the caption.
Senate Bill 16 by Senator Watson of the First and others, a bill will be titled an act to amend Article 8 of Chapter 12, Title 16 and Code Section 31 2A, 18 of the CGA, relating to the regulation of low THC oil and the establishment of the low THC oil patient registry and for other purposes. That concludes the order.
Chair recognizes Senator from the First to speak to his motion.
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise to speak to Senate Bill 16. I am very happy to say that we have been working together. The Senate has been working with the House, and let me stress that, working with the House on Senate Bill 16. Let me just give you a recap of what this does. Senate Bill 16 takes the THC level back from 3% up to 5%. But what we have required is that the physicians that are prescribing the THC oil report the percentage that will be used in this particular medicine. And I do say medicine because there are certainly multitudes of anecdotal evidence, there's observational data, but unfortunately there are no randomized controlled trials. So let me begin by saying what I said here just a few weeks ago. Mr. Trump and now Dr. Price and our former Governor Perdue, please allow the FDA and DEA to tear down that wall, tear it down and allow a Schedule 1, which is THC and THCA, to be used and to be studied. Let us move it from a Schedule 1 to a Schedule 1B, create this schedule, and allow randomized controlled trials at universities and medical centers around the United States. We cannot ignore any further the anecdotal and observational data, and we need good data. Only that will allow us. The federal government has placed the states in this precarious position. Having said that, I think the Senate is in a great position. I think that we have been working with the House on this, and let me just go over a few more details. What we have re-added is severe and end stage to cancer and all the other diagnoses there, which includes peripheral neuropathy, AIDS, epidermolysis bullosa, Alzheimer's, Tourette's, and we have now added what I think is most appropriate is for hospice patients. We've also added in a provision that will allow children to visit their grandparents here in the state of Georgia that would give a temporary registration if they have a registrar's card from another state for the diagnoses that are approved here in the state of Georgia, then that percentage, then that will be allowed for 45 days so that we can visit. Let me end it with a parent that is here today. Sarah and Dale Jackson began treating Colin on March 3rd, 2016, right before he turned 8 years old. Over the past 12 months, Dale says that his first have happened. And let me say, there are now four firsts that Colin has undertaken. Colin is a severely autistic child, is nonverbal, but now they can go out in public and eat stress-free in a restaurant. He has started feeding himself some foods. For the first time, Colin is less than a year, he started to take afternoon naps, which has allowed him to grow. More importantly, just this past week, he said for the first time, his first word, Mama. When it comes to this agreement to Senate Bill 16.
Chair recognizes Senator from the third for a question. Question.
Senator Yeal.
Yes.
Just a quick question. In the original version, we reduced the THC level from 5 to 3. Does this go back up to 5?
It goes back up to 5, and we're going to track it over the next 2 or 3 years to see what actual percentage will be used.
Thank you.
Yes. Mr. President, if there are no more questions, I yield the well.
Chair recognizes Senator from the 28th speak to the bill.
Thank you, Mr. President. Today I rise in support of SB 16. First, I want to thank the Lieutenant Governor, Senator from the 1st, Senator from the 13th, and all their hard work and willingness to work with the House on coming to this agreement. Today, we're going to provide more access for Georgians with very specific illnesses, and we're going to provide the doctors with more treatment options for these patients. Now, you heard the happy story of Colin saying his first words. And the sad part of that story is that we have forced our parents to choose between their children and the law. Today, they don't have to make that choice anymore. I want to tell you another tragic story. Got a constituent, 9-year-old, from Willis Road Elementary, Cooper Fuller. Cooper's been on medications, and he's had his seizures under control for the past 10 months. And his parents were wanting to try cannabis, but chose to continue on the current medications, which seemed to be working. Well, on Monday, Cooper went to be with the Lord. And I tell you that story because every day children are losing their lives. And if we continue to not do what's right, more children will die. More people will die. So I urge you, I plead with you, please vote for this bill. Let's continue moving down this path of getting the right medications to the right people. Thank you. With that, I yield the well.
Thank you, Senator. Senators, move that the Senate agree to the House substitute to SB 16. All those in favor will vote aye. Those opposed, no. Secretary will unlock the machine. The motion to agree to the House substitute, the yeas are 45 and the nays are 6, and this bill AMC Rex Constitution majority is therefore adopted. Chair recognized Senator 27th. Anyone know where the Senator from the the 45th. You got it.
Thank you, Mr. President. Is it 109? I move that the Senate agree to the House amendment to SB 109.
Read the caption.
Senate Bill 109 by Senator Williams of the 27th House, a bill be titled Enactment in Chapter 3 of Title 30 of the OCJA relating to emergency management so as to provide for the enactment of the recognition of emergency medical services personnel licensure interstate compact and for other purposes. The House offers the following amendment. Amend Senate Bill 109 by inserting after severability on line 12 of the following to amend Chapter 26 of Title 43 of the OCJA relating to nurses so as to enter into an interstate compact known as the Nurse Licensure Compact and for other purposes. That concludes the order.
Chair recognized Senator from the 31st.
The House amendment to SB 109, I don't find that in my book. Is that being distributed, or have I missed something?
Should be in the book.
It would be immediately preceding or after
on SB 109.
I don't have it in my booklet.
The white sheet?
I got the white sheet. That's the as passed version. The amendment is what I'm looking for. Not in mine.
Have you found it? You do have it. Okay. Chair recognizes Senator from the 27th to speak to the motion.
Thank you, Mr. President, members of the Senate. SB 109 is the EMS bill that allows for an interstate compact between multiple states that allows emergency service personnel to come into the state and work in case of natural disaster. The House attached to that the nursing compact, and I would like to yield the rest of my time to the senator from the 45th to explain the nursing compact.
No questions. Chair recognizes Senator from the 45th to speak.
Thank you, Mr. President. In the course of this session, we've had three compacts come through the General Assembly. One was about athletic trainers, one was the nurse compact, and one was the emergency medical services. What they did was attach the nurse compact, and in the spirit of taking care of all Georgians, the over 150,000 registered nurses and licensed practical nurses in the state of Georgia, this gives the ability for them to be able to move into the state and to get their license quickly so that they can go to work. We've talked repeatedly about rural health care and access to care. This is a method that they will be able to accomplish that. I'll be glad to yield for any questions. No questions, I yield the well and ask for your favorable consideration.
Question is on the motion of the senator to move it with Senate agree to the House amendment to SB 109. All those in favor will vote aye. Those opposed, no. Secretary will unlock the machine. Senator from the 7th will stand by. On the motion to agree to the House amendment to SB 109, the yeas are 51, the nays are 0, and the Senate has agreed. Chair recognizes Senator from the 7th.
Thank you, Mr. President. You know, in an effort for this body to show the support of our public safety community, our sheriff deputies, local police officers, state law enforcement, our correction officers, among many, many other public safety officials across this state, I move that the Senate agree to the House substitute to Senate Bill 160.
Read the caption.
Senate Bill 160 by Senators Harper the 7th and others, a bill be titled An act to amend Chapter 11, Title 15 of the OCJA relating to the Juvenile Code so as to revise the jurisdiction, definition, and penalties for certain crimes and offenses to add to the Superior Court's exclusive original jurisdiction the trial of any child 13 to 17 years of age who is alleged to have committed the offense of aggravated assault or aggravated battery upon a peace officer and for other purposes. Mr. President, the House offers the following substitute. Bill will be titled an act to provide for the increased punishment when certain crimes are committed against public safety officers to amend Chapter 11, Title 15, Title 16, and Code Section 45985 of the OCJA relating to the Juvenile Code, crimes and offenses, and payment of indemnification for death or disability of certain public safety officers and for other purposes. That concludes the order.
Chair recognizes Senator from 7th to present the bill.
Thank you, Mr. President. Ladies and gentlemen, the Senate, as y'all know, a couple of weeks ago, we had our Back the Badge Day in the Senate, and we passed out a number of pieces of legislation and sent them over to the House in support of our law enforcement and public safety community across the state. And we talked about how our public safety community has come over under fire, and we wanted to send a strong message that we support our law enforcement and public safety community and to let them know that we're behind them. So I stand before you today with Senate Bill 160, and hopefully we will agree to final passage and send this bill on to the governor to send a strong message to our public safety community. I'm going to go over the changes real briefly of what was in Senate Bill 160 and what's been changed in the House. The current bill that you have laying before you combines four pieces of legislation: the original Senate Bill 160, the original Senate Bill 154 in a modified form, House Bill 258, and House Bill 116. I was pleased to work with the Senator from the 13th, Representative Alan Powell, the Chairman of the Public Safety Committee, along with Representative Burt Reeves, in drafting the language that you have laying on your desk to make sure that we're able to show our public safety community how much we support them and that we're behind them 100%. In regards to what's changed in the underlying bill, we made some adjustments to the definitions to make sure that it's clear that we're talking about only those individuals that wear a badge. The other part that we changed, we added in House Bill 258, which dealt with the use of a firearm and aggravated assault, and it increased the mandatory minimum to 10 years. We scaled back the mandatory minimum when you use other items from firearms from 5 to 3 years. Both of those minimums, however, can be departed from if agreed to by the prosecutor, the defendant, and the defense attorney, and also the judge. So those mandatory minimums can be departed from in the court of law. The other thing that was added was provisions of Senate Bill 154, which imposed civil fines on these actions, and that money will go to the indemnification fund, which was also increased from $100,000 to $150,000. If you'll remember, in the original 160, under the obstruction, we increased the maximum from 5 to 15. We took the provisions of House Bill 258, where it was based on a number of offenses. Under the first offense is from 1 to 5, the second's 2 to 10, and the third offense is 3 to 15. We also clarified the language under the obstruction code in regards to the items being thrown or projected to make sure that it's clear we're referring to individuals that are willfully and knowingly doing that. We wanted to make sure that that is the intent, as that is the intent of the law and what the intent of the original bill was, and we added language to make over my objection, but the provision in regards to blocking a road, the increase in penalty in that provision, that was removed from the original bill, and I know that some members of this body had issue with that. However, I do have concern with that being removed, but I am okay with it, and I am good with the underlying bill, and hope that you will agree that this is a great piece of legislation to be able to send our law enforcement a message that we support them. So I would appreciate your favorable consideration. If there are no questions, I yield the will, Mr. President.
There are no questions, Senator. Senator has moved. The Senate agreed to the House substitute to SB 160 as amended. All of those in favor will vote aye. Those opposed, no. Secretary, unlock the machine. On the motion to agree, the yeas are 49, the nays are 3, and the Senate has moved to agree to the House substitute to 160. Chair recognized Senator from the 49th.
Wave off, Mr. President.
No. Senator from the 49th.
Beg your pardon, Mr. President. I move that the Senate agree to the House substitutes for Senate Bill 121 as amended by the Senate. I thought I'd been visited by a senator from the 53rd.
Senate Bill 121 by Senator Miller of the 49th and others, a bill will be titled an act to amend Article 6 of Chapter 4 of Title 26 of the OCJA relating to pharmacy so as to provide that the state health officer may issue a standing order permitting certain persons and entities to obtain opioid antagonists under the conditions the state health officer may impose to provide for immunity and for other purposes. Mr. President, the Senate offers the following amendment. Amend the House Committee on Judiciary's non-civil substitute to Senate Bill 121 by inserting after matters on line 8 the following to provide for an effective date by replacing up to with a minimum of on lines 26 and 29 and for other purposes. That concludes the order.
Chair recognized Senator from the 49th present, speak to his motion.
Thank you, Mr. President. This is just a simple change to agree with the production of the product, naloxone, and it changed the dosage, and as a matter of the manufacturers is why we had to change it. If there are no questions, I'll yield the will.
No questions, Senator. Senators, move that we, the Senate, agree to the House substitute to Senate Bill 121 as amended by the Senate. All those in favor will vote aye. Those opposed, no. Secretary will unlock the machine. On the motion, the yeas are 52 and the nays are 0, and the Senate has agreed. Chair recognized Senator from the 53rd.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move that the Senate agree to the House substitute to Senate Bill 88 as amended by the Senate.
Read the caption.
Senate Bill 88 by Senator Moles of the 53rd and others, a bill will be titled an act to amend Chapter 5 of Title 26 of the OCJA relating to drug abuse treatment and education programs so as to provide for regulation of narcotic treatment programs for other purposes. Mr. President, the Senate offers the following amendment. Amend the House substitute to Senate Bill 88 by striking lines 262 and 263 and inserting in lieu thereof the following D subsections B and C of this code section shall not apply to drug-dependent pregnant females. That concludes the order.
Chair recognized Senator from 53rd present.
Thank you, Mr. President. The adjustment that we made to the House version was that they had some incorrect information, and this deals with pregnant women in drug treatment, and they're already covered in the federal statute that's related to this bill. So we adjusted how the House put it in there. And that's the substance to this amendment to the original bill. Mr. President, be glad to answer any questions. If not, I yield the well. Appreciate your vote to move it back over to the House so we can have conclusion with this bill.
Right. Chair recognizes Senator from the 45th for a question.
Would the chairman yield?
Certainly.
Chairman, let me just say, we enjoyed your music this year in the Rules Committee.
Ah, thank
great.
You, my dear.
We enjoyed.
You were an inspiration to much of it.
Whatever. Okay, so we were looking at this bill, and this is about the methadone treatment centers, and I think they put the road demon bill in it.
What?
What is in it?
No.
The road demon bill is in it, or?
That would be incorrect if that's it. The part that I was talking about was dealing with pregnant women, so there's an error in this bill there. Yeah, how about that? Mr. President, there's an error here, so we probably need to rework this. I don't know how that's in there. You know, occasionally in a perfect world, things are not perfect. And apparently there's some error in the development of this legislation.
This is a House road naming bill.
It may be in your book, correct?
Senate road naming bill.
This is a misprint.
In the book, it is correct, Mr. President.
It's a misprint. In the book, it's correct, though, right?
No.
Is it not?
It's a misprint. They put it on the desk.
Is the one on the desk?
The
one that's been delivered to you on the desk is correct. That's the one I was referring to, actually. I didn't know the other one was in there. Hey, this is still not correct.
The correct copy is on the desk. It's on your desk, not the one in the book. Senator, Chair recognizes Senator from the 31st. Step out of the well, Senator from the 53rd for a second. Chair recognizes Senator from the 31st. What purpose you rise?
Our desk, SB 88, they have identical LC numbers and they contain different language. That causes me to question everything that we do in here, because I had always felt like that through the legislative management system that there was integrity in the legislation. And now, I mean, I don't understand how any document could be created that has identical LC numbers on it, yet grossly different language. And when we agree to the House substitute as amended, while you say that we're referring to the second copy, there's nothing, I don't understand the mechanism that would ensure that we don't ultimately adopt the first
Senator,
copy.
Senator, look at the one that was a misprint. Look at
I'm
the second.
I'm not sure I know which one that is.
Senator, let's not question the integrity of the office of the Secretary of the Senate. They're doing the very best they can to prepare everything. And with all that being said, this was a misprint and a mistake. Look at the second page in the LC number. You will see that it is different. And
okay, I see that. So now.
That's totally different.
Can we refer to, I mean, how do we resolve this? I see the second page says SB 204.
Correct. That was it, when they were putting it together, they made a mistake.
It's a printing error.
It's a print. That's what we said. It's a printing error.
Thank you.
So everyone has the correct LC number on your desk regarding SB 88. Still have some lights on. Are you wishing to speak? A question? Senator from the 53rd, if you would come back to the well, your chair recognizes Senator 29th for a question.
Thank you, Mr. President. Will the senator yield?
Yes, yes.
I just wanted to ask, I know that the version that passed the Senate, there was a limitation in terms of how many of these clinics could operate in a given region.
That's
is correct. That language in the version that is now before us, or was that changed by the House?
It should be in there. Now, the change that we're offering is not that, so I was just referring to the changes that we're offering. That should be in here. I'll be glad to come back and point that out to you.
Thank you, Senator. If you could just point out to me the lines when you get a chance, I'd appreciate it.
Thank you, Senator.
Chair recognizes Senator from the 39th for a question. 39th, your light was on. Did you have a question? Nope. Waved off. Okay. Very good. No further questions, Senator.
Thank you. I appreciate your help.
Senators move the Senate agree to the House substitute to SB 88 as amended by the Senate. All of those in favor will vote aye. Those opposed, no. Secretary, unlock the machine. On the passage, or on the motion, the yeas are 46, the nays are 5, and the Senate has agreed. Secretary will, or excuse me, Chair recognizes Senator from the 11th.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move that the Senate agree to the House substitute to Senate Bill 180 as amended.
Read the caption.
Senate Bill 180 by Senators Burke of the 11th and others, a bill be titled an act to amend Article 1 of Chapter 8 of Title 31 of the OCGA relating to hospital care for the indigent generally so as to provide for an additional reporting requirement for rural hospitals, to amend Article 3 of Chapter 7 of Title 48 of the OCGA relating to the imposition rate computation exemptions from income taxes so as to change certain amounts and entities eligible for the credit and for other purposes. Mr. President, the Senate offers the following amendment. Amend the House substitute to Senate Bill 180 by deleting all matter from line 1 through the end and substituting lieu thereof the following to amend Article 1 of Chapter 8 of Title 31 of the OCGA relating to hospital care for the indigent generally so as to provide for a definition, provide for an additional reporting requirement for rural hospitals, to amend Article 2, Chapter 7, Title 48 of the OCGA relating to the imposition rate computation exemption from income taxes and for other purposes. That concludes the order.
Chair recognizes Senator from the 11th. Speak to the motion.
Thank you, Mr. President. The House bill that came over, or the House changes to Senate Bill 180 that came over, had the nurse and PA preceptor language in it. That was removed. We're accepting the House change of 80% to 90% on the tax credit. There was one other minor change requested by Department of Revenue on reporting from hospitals that we made. Those were the changes in this version. Be glad to answer questions, Mr. President.
You do have a question. Chair recognizes the minority leader, the Senator from the 41st.
Senator, yield.
I'll yield for the minority leader.
Isn't it true that when this first came through, the percentage of deduction was 70%?
That was as passed last year.
And isn't it true that when we talked about it at that time, we also talked about if these funds were actually in the general budget and not given in tax breaks, we could use that money to draw down federal matching dollars, and actually there was the possibility to more effectively use these tax dollars?
I think the minority leader has made his point on every occasion that he's been able to, so.
Thank you. And isn't that true that it will be increasing not only the percent of money and the amount that people will get, it's for the next year, it's actually increasing the cap level, so that will even be more money we won't have to bring down federal matching dollars for next year.
The initial bill that we passed last year had $180 million over 3 years, escalating from 50 to 60 to 70. This one just leaves it flat every year, 60, 60, and 60. Over 3 years, the net amount of money is the same. Then no further questions, I'll yield the well.
No questions, Senator. Senators moving, the Senate agree to the House substitute to HB 180 as amended. All those in favor will vote aye. Those opposed, no. Secretary will unlock the machine. We're going to take our lunch break after this bill. On the passage of the bill, the yeas are 42 and the nays are 9, and the Senate has agreed to the House substitute as amended. We will be back. We'll take an hour break. Be back at 2 o'clock.